Gutterman Group is a go. Oh.
Yes! Not just a startup, an upstart.
Gotta get going.
Gotta be good.
Good?
Good.
Growth is the goal. How do we do that?
I talked to UPS. They'll help us out. New technology, smart advice. We focus on the business, and they take care of the logistics.
UPS.
Good going.
We get good. That's great.
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 Great. Great.
I love logistics.
Akron holds off Kent State 53-51 in a thriller in the third round of the MAC tournament. The Zips took the lead with 38 seconds to go after DG Ibitayo knocked down two free throws, but the defense needed one final stop. Kent State had a chance with 7 seconds left to tie or win the game, but the Zips defense didn't let the Golden Flashes get a shot off.
Well, it was a grinded out, typical Akron Kent game. A little less scoring than most, but we did what we had to do to win, really. We can't afford to play in the 70s with them. We need to play it down in here. I just wish we would have shot it a little bit better, but neither team really shot the ball very well, but it was a good ball game, exciting game. It was like a trip to the dentist today. I mean, it's frustrating because both teams struggled to score. So like you're in there and you're the Novocaine's wearing off and you're just trying to get through the visit, right? And but it was an interesting game from the perspective of, like, we've been in a lot of those games, so I'm proud of how our guys handled it at the end. We made some big shots that we hadn't made most of the year, but we've been in a bunch of those. And probably the thing that I liked the best is Antonio Jackson was 0-for-6 the first half and had his struggles, but he just drove our car, right? And he never quit, and he had a heart of a lion. And I think that's why we won the game. I thought they did a terrific job of game planning and scouting. They did a really good job on our shooters and basically made us score in the post. And then we struggled to score a little bit in the post. I thought Jimmy Hall played well in the post defensively. But we felt like at halftime, we were down 8 at their place at halftime. And then we were down 8 tonight, and we felt better about ourselves at Kent because the ball was going in the basket a little bit more. So I told our guys, look, really, this is our kind of a game. Kent really doesn't want to play down in here, right? We do, right? So for us, it was better to grind it out than to try to outscore them because we're probably not going to beat them in that. And we just felt like, you know, they did such a good job scouting us, I had to pull something out that they haven't really seen. And, you know, he just made it. I give him a lot of credit. That's a tough shot to make at that time of the game. We're down 4. We're in big trouble, right? If he doesn't make that, the game's over, really. But we chose to shoot the 3, which that's great coaching. 5-for-24, right? And you shoot the 3. But you got to live with what brought you, right? And we just felt like that was a good play for us.
Keith Dambrot said a big reason that the Zips were able to pull it out in the second half was the play of Antonio Jackson. The freshman point guard scored 9 of his 11 points in the final 20 minutes, while Pat Forsyth came off the bench to score a team-high 12 points. The Zips moved to 21-13 overall and advanced to the MAC tournament semifinals and have a date with Buffalo tomorrow night here in Cleveland. Reporting from Quicken Loans Arena, I'm David Suntup for GoZips.com.